Welcome to Prostate Pros Podcast. We're guiding you to treatment success and avoiding prostate cancer pitfalls. I'm your host, Dr. Mark Scholz, here with my co-host Liz, and today's guest, Alex Scholz.
Thank you. It's really great to be here.
Dr. Scholz, can we get some insight first on what the PCRI is, since you're one of the original co-founders?
Yeah, the PCRI was founded by Dr. Steven Strum and myself over 20 years ago to help patients learn about prostate cancer. As everyone has learned already, prostate cancer is very complex, and it's a strange throwback with the world of prostate cancer, sort of a backwards industry, because it's the only type of cancer where surgeons are operating in the primary care position. So Dr. Strum and I, being medical oncologists, thought early on that it would be very helpful to provide educational resources for patients as they're reflecting on all their many different treatment options. Our first employee was Harry Pinchot, called Helpline Harry. Harry would answer phone calls from all over the country from men who were interested in selecting their different treatment options.
He said to me, "You've kind of come into a fraternity now." And that's what PCRI offers in the conference.
You hear presentations from renowned doctors and researchers in regards to prostate cancer. More specifically, you hear them talk about therapies and treatments and advanced imaging technologies.
After each of these meetings, they had an opportunity where you could ask them individual questions.
And then there's a summary, which I like the best, and it's a sort of a recap of what each of the experts in the field had to say.
I left with a sense of there's hope. You know, yeah, this is scary, but there are people on my team now that I trust. And whatever I decide, I know that I'm getting good information.
We've talked a little bit about the support men get at the PCRI conferences. I wanted to follow up on that with Alex Scholz, who is the CEO of the PCRI. Welcome, Alex. We're glad to have you today.
Thank you so much for having me.
Alex, I'd love to hear a little bit more about the helpline, but the 2019 patient conference is coming up fast. So can we talk a little bit about that first?
Absolutely. September 6th, 7th, and 8th, we have a prostate cancer patient conference. And there's a lot of conferences out there on prostate cancer, but what sets this conference apart, it's absolutely 100% designed with the patient and the caregiver in mind. Our job is to make sure that their questions get answered. And there's a lot of information in prostate cancer around lifestyle and side effects and treatment. And we want to make sure that they get to have their questions answered by experts. So from all over the world, we have experts coming in those types of treatments, in those types of situations to help guide these patients to the right choices for themselves.
So I went to the Mid-Year conference in March, and it was my first experience with PCRI. And I got to sit in on a couple talks. I was getting the answers to questions I didn't really know I had. And a lot of those were I didn't know a lot about testosterone and hormone therapy. So I'm curious if in the annual conference, there'll be more on that, or what kind of topics are you covering?
Yes, there will. So our job at the September conference, you know, you mentioned the mid-year, that's in March. And so we have two conferences every year, one in the spring and one in the fall. And the fall conference is really designed to cover all topics of prostate cancer. So we will be covering, you know, testosterone, hormone therapy, side effects. We'll be covering advanced treatments, you know, active surveillance with Gleason 6. There's no aspect of prostate cancer that's not covered. And how that is designed is through our staging system. The audience themselves takes our quiz, which is 6 questions, and they are separated into groups according to their stage. The benefits of that are, number one, they get to hear about all the treatments available to them within that stage, not just one, so it's not divided into treatment. And they also get to talk to other prostate cancer patients who have been through similar situations because they're all in the same room together, and then hear from an expert in that stage themselves and who can speak to any question that they ask. The entire conference is designed with that format in mind, as well as all the other information they need to know about diet, lifestyle, nutrition, supplements, everything, including exercise, and we try to cover every aspect.
I'm glad Alex mentioned the quiz. This was implemented in our conference for the first time last year, and the power of being able to speak to a subgroup of men with the same stage is amazing. When I'm speaking to a general prostate cancer audience, I often have to remember that I have men in the room that have practically harmless types of cancer and others that have life-threatening types of prostate cancer, almost like different illnesses. And it can be quite confusing speaking to such a diverse group. What a pleasure it was to talking to a segment of men that have the same type of prostate cancer. Our September conference this year is going to follow that format again.
You can find that quiz at key2pc.com.
Let me just jump in here. The changes that are going on in imaging have been revolutionary over the last 10 years. As Alex pointed out, 3T MRIs have completely altered the way we think about diagnosing prostate cancer, and it's been a great upgrade. A lot safer, a lot more accurate than the old-fashioned random biopsies. Another big imaging breakthrough is called the PSMA PET scan. These new PET scans are not yet FDA approved, but they are available at a variety of centers across the country through clinical trials. What's remarkable is these scans are able to localize prostate cancer in the body when the PSA is less than one. We've never had technology like this before. So this is coming and it's going to affect all the stages and the way we manage prostate cancer going forward. And I'm sure we'll be having information at the conference to help people understand better what this scan can offer them.
I went into the mid-year conference with kind of a narrow focus on wanting to learn about more about testosterone therapy. And you talked a lot about different topics that'll be at the yearly conference that I'm really excited to learn more about. And I'm sure the same thing will happen when I go in and I have all these questions I didn't know I have, and I learn a whole bunch of new information about prostate cancer and men's health. And I'm just excited to see what's going to happen at the yearly.
One thing we haven't mentioned about the conference is our fearless leader, Dr. Mark Moyad from Michigan University. Dr. Moyad has really carried this conference on his shoulders for a number of years. He provides such clear, scintillating insights and does a great job at drawing the best out of these speakers. And he's got a wonderful sense of humor. We all have a really good time together.
Okay, Alex, so what feedback are you getting from these yearly conferences?
Every year with these conferences, we do surveys afterwards in order to find out, did the patient's questions get answered? What topics are they looking for? Did the caregivers' needs, were they met? And so our conferences being designed for patients, we rely heavily on that feedback in order to adjust our topics and the design of the conference and future conferences. So some of the feedback we got is they love the staging. So like Dr. Scholz mentioned, we did that for the first time, breaking out the sessions into staging sessions for our breakouts. They really appreciated that, but they wanted more on diet and lifestyle. They wanted more on incontinence and erectile dysfunction and things like that. Things that surround prostate cancer and are effects of prostate cancer, affected, you know, in prostate cancer. Every year we take that feedback and we design it. So this year we have every topic. Again, we have the stages, but we're also going to be covering, you know, what do you do in chemo situations and radiation and hormone therapy, you know, immunotherapies, what's out there in the world when, you know, the new advances in medical, the medical system is so exciting, what's happening in the medical field with all these new drugs coming out. You know, they have all these new second generation hormone therapies. So we're going to be covering all of that, the new advances, the latest information. And we feel it's really important that patients stay up to date because they may think, oh, well, I know the standard treatments out there, but so much has changed in the landscape that they don't know the new treatments that are coming out and it could be applicable to them. That's really our focus.
It kind of has a focus on new treatments and probably new imaging techniques. I know that's something that I got asked about a lot at the conference was, where do I find what facilities that are best to get imaged at? And the great thing was I had just looked at your website and I had found your imaging section. Can we talk a little bit about that?
Yes, so you can find that at pcri.org/imaging. Basically, what that is for patients who need to get, you know, see their prostate. They want to see what's going on and know the size of their prostate. Is there any cancer nodes and not have a random needle biopsy, but have a targeted biopsy? That's the reason we designed. We're very passionate that they don't get random needle biopsies, that they get targeted biopsies. And so we wanted to provide a list of centers, according to state, that have 3T, which is Tesla, 3T. Tesla MRI machines that'll give them the best picture so they can have educated conversations with their doctor, and their doctor can help them decide on the best form of treatment, seeing where the cancer is at. And so we have a list according to state. They can just click on their state. It'll scroll down automatically, and we try to make it as user-friendly as possible.
We get a lot of comments on our social media from men saying, I wish I had known more before deciding on treatment, or I rushed into treatment before I had any idea that these resources even existed. And one thing about the PCRI's website that's really cool is that it's organized by stage. If I know I'm a teal, I can click the teal square, and then I'm just directed right to all the information, including new information about teal. And it's just a really easy way to stay organized and up to date. So the book, Key to Prostate Cancer, is also organized by stage. So that's a really great resource. If you don't have access to pick that up, you can find the staging quiz on key2pc.com.
So on PCRI.org, you know, we mentioned the quiz and people taking it at the conference, but we actually have it on our website as well and the staging system so they can answer those six questions and get to their particular stage. And it's become very popular. It's only been out for about a year and a half to 2 years, and we've had about 13,000 people take it. And it's been really interesting just seeing the effect that that has on the patient, being able to answer six questions, know which stage they're in, and see what treatments are available and the side effects associated, again, with lifestyle. You know, you're not going to have somebody in a Gleason 9 be offered active surveillance when they're obviously in a more advanced stage. And so being able to bring clarity to that situation through the staging system is something we're really excited about.
I've put on my calendar September 6th through 8th for the conference, so I'm clear that weekend.
That's awesome. Really looking forward to you being there. We're really excited to have patients and caregivers come. It's completely designed for them, as we've mentioned. And if they'd like to come, they can register at PCRI.org. Our early bird registration ends September 1st. Come to the conference, get your questions answered, meet other people, meet support group leaders, experts, come meet the PCRI team. We would love to walk alongside you in this journey of prostate cancer, and we're really passionate about you.
It's okay to pause this podcast and go register now. It's PCRI.org. So I've already registered for the September conference, and I have a couple questions that I am kind of excited to hear the answers for.
First of all, they can submit their questions to us beforehand as they think about them at PCRI.org/2019-conference. And so we have a button there. They can just fill out their question, fill out if they'd like it to be for a specific speaker or just in general. And we get all of those and bring those to the conference with us. At the conference, in every single session, we do allow time for Q&A. And so they can either use the question cards that's provided to them in their program books. They can text us their questions at the number in their program books. It's also on the screens. And then they can email their questions at questions@pcri.org. So we have multiple ways for their questions to get answered. A lot of guys come and stand in line, and when the speaker comes off the stage, he's always available to answer questions. And we also have what we kind of call the press room. After the speaker gets off the stage and Dr. Mark Moyad moderates some of the questions from the audience, but also his own, the patients can go to the press room and the speaker will come and answer their individual questions there as well in person. And that's a really great format because they get to hear what he's telling other patients and those situations, how it applies to them. So it's a really good setup for that.
What are some common questions or like prostate cancer myths that you find a lot of people asking?
One of the myths that, you know, kind of happened with the government, you know, saying that PSA testing really isn't relevant. That's a myth. PSA testing is absolutely relevant. It may not tell you exactly what's wrong, but it is telling you that there is something wrong and your PSA is elevated. Maybe you have BPH, prostatitis, or it could be prostate cancer. So when guys call us and they say, should I really get my PSA tested? Yes. Yes, absolutely. Please do so. So that's one myth. Another myth we get is that Gleason 6 surgery in general, do I need surgery? Are the, you know, side effects really my urologist telling me I'm going to have no side effects? Really? Statistically, no side effects. Great. No, you will have some form of side effects most likely. A lot of guys call us and just say, when it comes to surgery, what do I need to know? What is he not telling? They do need to know that you don't need to just rush to surgery, that you have time. You have time to make your decision. Thinking in that form, like, that's a huge myth to me. There is time to make your decision, even in the most advanced cases. And surgery, no, is not your best option. And yes, it most likely will have side effects. And another thing that I think is really important is, especially in the rushing process, is that one of the things that we get calls about is, you know, hey, my doctor says I have a rising PSA and he's sending me to a random needle biopsy and he tells me I need this right away. And the urologist is saying I need this right away. Is that true? And no, that's a myth too. So you can, you know, we already talked about the imaging, the 3T MRI imaging that they can do. So they can do a targeted biopsy and not have to have, you know, 14 to 12 cores, you know, in their prostate, and maybe have 2 to 3 cores, depending on the image and where they see the node or the possible cancer, and really biopsy that section and not the entire prostate. Those are kind of the major things that we hear a lot in prostate cancer that still surprise us. Like 3T MRI is all over the country. Why are we not doing this standard? Yes. Your PSA is a check engine light. You absolutely should be checking your PSA and using it to just say, something's a little amiss here. Let me see what this is. And yeah, you know, when it comes to surgery, there's definitely a lot more side effects. And unfortunately, we get the calls from the men that are dealing with those side effects and we're told that wasn't going to happen. They're having erectile dysfunction and urinary incontinence, and they're dealing with these issues. And sometimes it's permanent. You know, you get a guy getting surgery at like 52 and he's having to deal with that, you know, for the rest of his life.
Yeah, a lot of those sound like people that have just fallen into all of the myths we hear about prostate cancer and are just getting this kind of treatment regret because of all the media and doctors' beliefs around prostate cancer that maybe don't know as much about it as the specialist does.
I'm a helpline facilitator at the PCRI.
And like you, I'm also a patient.
I have studied and researched every aspect of prostate cancer and learned
everything I could to tackle my own disease.
We've been through circumstances similar to yours.
We understand the challenges.
And we are more than happy to help.
Give us a call anytime.
We will help you find the information you need
to make the best treatment decisions for yourself.
So the phone number for the PCRI's helpline is 310-743-2116. You guys are really giving a lot of information. You have the conferences, which happen twice a year. You have the helpline.
One of the cool things about the conference too is the fact that our helpline team, we take calls from all around the country 24/7, 7 days a week when it comes into emails and phone calls, answering prostate cancer questions. And we've been able to build relationships with these patients and walk alongside them through their journey. And those same prostate cancer facilitators are going to be at the conference. So they can talk to somebody over the phone and then meet them in person and have ongoing conversations. The patients come up that have been on helpline and go and find, you know, Jonathan or Bob or Sylvia or whoever, Nathan, who's on helpline. What do you think about that? I just heard the speaker say this and I need clarity and I need you to, how does this apply to my situation since we've been talking about it? Kind of brings, you know, the PCRI full circle a little bit when they get to meet whoever they've been talking to over the phone. And they've had advanced prostate cancer and they've been through multiple treatments, but they've also been trained by Dr. Scholz and a medical advisory board and have trained in prostate cancer for months before they're ever even on a phone call with a patient. And so they've had a lot of experiences. They stay up to date. They shadow Dr. Scholz in clinic. And so they get a lot of training, and our job is to make sure that they stay up to date so they can tell you the latest information and really build it around your stage. Anyone, you know, prostate cancer patients, we get a lot of caregivers, a lot of wives that call, and it's 100% free, and we are definitely here for you. One of the other ways that they can reach Helpline is our email at helpline@pcri.org.
So I've read on the PCRI website that part of the mission is to make sure that providers and physicians are also kept up to date on the most recent advances in prostate cancer. And that's also something we're trying to do with this podcast. It's definitely for patients and caregivers, but it's also for doctors in the hope that this information can kind of start to turn the industry and make just everyone be on the same page, whether it's with how we treat Gleason 6 or targeted biopsies. It's important that doctors also stay up to date on this information. And I think that nonprofits like the PCRI can help a lot with that because the information's easy to read and process quickly.
We're in a time right now in the field of medicine that is expanding and growing at a faster rate that's ever occurred in history. And the medical industry is not very well prepared to incorporate all this new information in their day-to-day practices. It's just too much information. The responsibility then starts to fall back on the patient's shoulders. You yourself have to look out for your own health to make sure that you're getting the latest, most up-to-date care. Today, it really matters. When I first started doing this 20, 25 years ago, medicine changes were occurring at a snail's pace, but now they're changing week to week, month to month. So the PCRI's goal is to get all this new information out in an understandable format for patients to be able to present to their physicians and to be able to get the most up-to-date care.
We have our website, PCRI.org, as we mentioned, and that not only has all of our articles, our newsletters posted there, we have lots of blogs and the latest updates, press releases, and prostate cancer. We also have our video library, which is based from our YouTube channel. So YouTube /the PCRI, that's our YouTube channel. And currently we have, at least 270 videos posted. We post 3 to 5 times a week on every aspect of prostate cancer. And so the website's flooded with those videos as well. And we also have a prostate cancer staging series with, we have the quiz, but we also have a staging guide. And so we can mail that out, email it to anybody who needs it. And that's kind of the short version of Dr. Scholz's book, The Key to Prostate Cancer. So it's kind of a summary. It's definitely not as in-depth as the book, but it's a really great starting place. We send that to over 260 support groups in the country, and we actually have presentations that we send them every other month to help them stay educated. And we also are doing a webinar in June on men's health. And so they can find more about that on the website at PCRI.org. So we have multiple facets, between the quiz and the video and the articles and a lot of different media in order to try to help prostate cancer patients learn in their form how they want to learn about prostate cancer and whatever media they prefer.
Again, we want to thank Alex for joining us today and telling us about all the different ways that PCRI helps men get information. Alex, we definitely want you to come back after the conference, and maybe you can fill us in on some of the important things that happened that listeners might have missed.
This has been so much fun today, having Alex tell us about the PCRI. And I know we have a lot of good stuff planned for you all in the future. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on our next episode. We're going to open the discussion with the just cut it out mentality that's so pervasive in this field.
You can email your questions and topics that you'd like to hear more on to podcast@prostateoncology.com. That's podcast@prostateoncology.com. If you like what you hear, please rate, review, and subscribe on iTunes.